I think I've been in a single project or two in my time where somebody would say, if you just compile this, and then it's like, yeah, I don't have that thing on my Linux, I don't have that thing, and so on. But I have a feeling that Julian can help me with that and have the right answer for that. Correct?
Correct.
Over to you.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'll be talking about how to set up a shareable dev environment in Docker. It's rather basic. I'll have the following agenda. First, I'll start with introduction. I'm Julian Grube. I work at semasquare. We are based in Bochum in the center of North Rhine-Westphalia. We do mainly software development for utility and service vehicles. For example, sweepers you see on every street. I have a small image. Those machines, we are now in the sixth interval of machines, but we also do different kinds of software development, but mostly focused on HMIs. The problem, as described already, works on my machine. They even put it on t-shirts now. Yeah. We develop for embedded systems, and those systems come with a rather big tool chain, and we have bigger teams, and everybody in the team has to develop software for the target hardware. And the usual case, everybody knows it, it works on my machine, but next developer checks the commit out and tries to run it, and it doesn't work. Or in a rather worse case, software runs on every developer machine, but not on the target hardware, which could be very bad. Also, there's lots of time wasted on onboarding and setting up systems for new colleagues, or the situation, can you please look at my merge request? Yeah. With Docker containers, we have a solution. I put here a quote from Wikipedia. It summarizes it very good. We have containers. We have it's more complicated in detail, but for a lightning talk, I think we'll scrape the surface and go with that. So Docker is a solution for the described problems. We have different requirements. First, we need Docker files. Then we'll need to run these Docker files. I'll show the way with a make file. And last but not least, we also need CI or registry to put these images we created. Yeah, it's a lot. It's a rather basic example of a Docker file we used for TopCon displays. As we heard in the first talk today, two-thirds of the people here use the online installer. We also use the online installer. It's a little problem if we want to do it automatically. So we use a rather useful script. It's also online, QtCI. We have to provide our login and password, and can select a Qt version we want to install in our Docker images. Then we run it, and it installs the selected Qt version. On the top, we have the selected repository. Yeah, Qt version I already explained, pass. We install some requirements we have. This is basic setup. If we have some time left at the end, we can look at a Docker file for an ARM image, for example. Once we finish this Docker file, we can go to the make file to start it. On the top, we have the Qt image we already we had in our repository or registry. We have three images here, one for local build, one for the target build, and one for Android images. In our build process, we just run the image or the compiled file. We have a build script here for Android, for TopCon, that's the hardware. That's our target, or just for the local build. There are some commands here that we'll see in the run. So I will explain them. This is the run. I'll start from the bottom. This is the file or the software we want to start. This is a Qt image we have seen already on the top here. We want some networking. We want to mount some folders into the Docker image. We mount a lot, and we need some variables for our software. That's the last tile, last part. In this example, we are using GitLab to as our CI to build these Docker images from the top to the bottom. Yeah, it's very basic, I think. We log into the Docker repository or registry. We build our image, and then we push it to the registry. I can show everything. This will start a build for our local file. We can also build for ARM, as mentioned. Stop it here, and we can also build for yeah, I'm not connected to network. Okay. Are there any questions?
Okay. I don't see any hands, so thank you very much.